Hello and thanks for staying with us. The Assistant Contractor General of Nigerian Customs Service in the country has started handing over to the new zonal coordinators all over the country. Plus, more report. I am Egeseme Edinye. Stay tuned. The newly appointed Assistant Contractor General of Nigerian Customs Service in charge of Zone A has resumed duty officially. The former ACG has officially handed over to the new ACG. Before the handing over ceremony, a guard of honor was mounted for the outgoing ACG. The new ACG was also welcomed with a guard of honor mounted by the Nigerian Customs Service.
To dismiss the guards into the guard room, sir. Sir, please stand fast. Demand the guard into the guard room. Dismiss.
At the handing over ceremony, all controllers operating the Western Zone were present at the occasion.
Zone A. Nigeria Customs Service.
Now, the zone raised 0.662 trillion naira. 0.662 trillion naira. And as a controller, PTML, Tinkan Island Ports, Airports, Apapa, and also as controller Joint Tax Force, Customs, ICPC, and EFCC, a total of 1.607 trillion was raised between me and my colleagues. I want to appreciate the Almighty God for the opportunity to serve as air controller in all of these commands, and also as a zonal coordinator of this zone. This zone comprises of all custom formations in southwest Nigeria. That is all custom formations in Lagos, Ogun, Oyo, Osun, Ekiti. Where else? All of them in southwest Nigeria, we are under my supervision. So, under my solution, we were able to generate 1.607 trillion naira into federal government coffers. I also want to appreciate the Comptroller General of Customs, Colonel Hamid Ibrahim Ali, who, in his wisdom, assigned me to this office that I am leaving this morning to my friend, my brother, my colleague, Monde Abue, MNI. All of these feats wouldn't have been possible if not for the fine officers and CGC posted here, the controllers, the area controllers who worked with me hand in hand and beautifully and then worked together to have raised this huge revenue. You recall last year the Controller General, Colonel Amin Ibrahim Ali, made some strategic moves and changes that brought in this new breed of customs area controllers that have joined hands with us to raise this revenue. So, CACs, we appreciate you. We appreciate your support. We appreciate your cooperation. I appreciate your listening to me. I appreciate all that we did together to raise this huge revenue for our country. I also want to appreciate the men and women in Mufti here, the journalists who have been a great support to me, I must particularly bring to fore the timely information, intelligence that you had given to us and given to me in particular, that had helped me in terms of anti-smuggling, then also in terms of revenue. Those informations you gave were valuable informations that we used and then used possibly. Most of them were timely and accurate. So we're saying thank you. I also want to appeal to the journalists. Please, the support you give to me, please double it and show it upon ACG Monday Abue, who took it over from me. So that he can also work, then also surpass the records that have been set here. Please, your cooperation with tax. Beyond him, support Nigerian Customs Service. Support the current Comptroller of Customs. Support all of us so that together we can make our country better than it is today.
As you are aware, Zone A is like a mini, you know, custom body. Because Zone A, you know, is the homeland of several area commands and other special units. And so, if Zone A should fail in the delivery of service, it's a very clear indicator that the entire customs service has failed. Am I right?
Yes.
And so, that is why, to be saddled with the responsibility of managing the affairs of Zone A, you must be very, very sound in customs duties. Well, there's always a notion when there are changes that is, you know, I know some people will always parade that they are, oh, they're removing, you know, they don't have removal to custom. Posting officers is a normal, you know, exercise that goes on every time. It's not a condemnation of those who were here before. But I believe that by being asked to manage the affairs of Zone A, I'm expected to improve on the successes that have been recorded. And that I promise to do. More importantly, we cannot succeed, you know, on our own. Because custom will normally work with intelligence. And some of the intelligence we expect that should be provided by the general trading public, the Nigerian public, and more especially the members of the press. So when you give out credible information, I assure you that we're not going to waste it. We will not waste it at all. And we'll get back to you how we have utilized that information. So I will certainly ask for a cooperation that is said that should extend the same level of cooperation that you accorded him.
No, I say times two.
Okay, times two. Or even more than that. You know, maybe in exponential manner, I don't know. So, and that's what we need here to succeed in what we're expected to do. I mean, like you know, the critical main function of customs is to collect revenue. Apart from that, there are security issues involved these days that we have proliferation of small arms here and there. So security issues, you know, will be pursued vigorously.
The controller in charge of Apar Command speaks on behalf of all controllers operating in the Western Zone.
I want to thank God Almighty for sparing our lives, getting to this moment where we witness yet another chapter in the history of the Nigerian Customs Service. What they say is only permanent in life is change. And we are here experiencing it. To us, it's a moment of different strokes. It is a mixture of, a moment of mixed blessing. At one moment, we are missing a very good leader who has given us, who has led us on a very glorious moment where we experienced some form of revolution in our operations generally. And we, in the process, have been able to improve on our core mandate, which is revenue generation. Our level of discipline has also improved. to a very, very high level. We actually leverage on that to achieve what we achieve. The common debt, like I said, is generation of revenue, combating of smuggling, promoting of compliant international trade. And this we have performed creditably well, I must say. On this note, I want to implore to indulge, you know, the cooperation of every person that is here, the stakeholders, the men of the press, officers of the service. Hands must all have to be on deck. This is something that we have to do together, collectively. There's no any better time than this, because the nation, I mean the economy of the nation, is in recession. It's on its knees, and it's only who can get it up to stand on its legs. And we can only do it by joining hands. Let us remain very, very patriotic. Let us remain very, very compliant. And this way, we can raise, you know, the level of the service to a higher level.
You are watching the program Customs Report. The Customs Area Controller in charge of KLT Command has been speaking to the Customs Report on how the Nigerian Customs Service will help to clear the Apapa road so that containers can pass through the port.
The successes that have been able to make it clear and make the other people who hitherto were not even concerned concerning this, and seeing that it is very important for us to sort this problem out. And such success have made it necessary for us to have implemented certain solutions, like the establishment of holding bays, which some private entities took on their own, invested their money and made this available. And these holding bays are still ongoing. The development of those holding bays are still ongoing. And we expect that this year we should increase the capacity of those holding bays to be put in place, functioning, so that the tank cars will now start parking in those places. The time those holding bays, the temporary holding bays were done, it was already towards the end of the year and the festive period catch up with us. So what we're going to do now is to sit down with the forum and do now do implementation strategy of gradual relocation of the traffic to that those places. And then the awareness also has made it possible for other government agencies to also start looking at the problem. And from information we had, the World Bank also has agreed to come into bringing money to make sure that this particular program is a success through the NPA. But the details of that, I'm sure, this also came out towards the end of last year. I'm sure the details of such a strategy and the investment that the World Bank is coming to bear on it will be clearer since it is being, you know, handled by the NPA. So, for I can see clearly that my arrival here and the exposure have brought the negative aspect of this traffic gridlock to the national economy has been properly put in its perspective.
Let's go to the issue of the revenue generation of your command since you took over last year in February up to date.
I reported here almost towards the end of January. I could say that properly I was on seat properly for the first week of February. And if we, from the statistics, you see that the first week of January, the first month of last year, in January, the command could only generate 23%. That is 190 million naira for the whole month. But in February, by the time I sat down and I looked at and I started adopting new strategies, I was able to move from that 23% and was able to successfully deliver 43% increase in revenue collection. That is, from 190 million, we now collected 350 million. From there, in the next month of March, we were able to collect over 57%. And that is from 350, we went to 467. Gradually, and it is how we continuously, up to August, by August, we were able to generate up to 94%. And that is, we generated even that single month. That means looking at 1st January, when we were barely making 200 million. In August, we succeeded, our strategy was paying off. And we were able to develop and generate over 768 million. So by September, we were able to generate about 926 million. And this trend continues like that. That means we deliver over 114%. So by December, we're trying to make sure that we close the year on a high note. And coupled with the discussion we had with our controller general, that our revenue target generally, holistically, that is nationally, needed some gaps. Because there were some gaps, so we should do double our effort. And we came now and make sure that at least we will close the year by high note and we're able to generate over 1 billion. That is, we were able to collect over 125% of the revenue target.
Recently, the Nigerian government decided to cut down duty on some consignment coming into the country. Some consignments were reduced from 10% to 5%. And also, the Semi Command has made a total of 1.5 billion naira in the month of December 2016. We now continue with the activities that took place in the Nigerian Customs Service in 2016, where a lot of policies were made by the government and some of them have been fully implemented. Stay tuned. The Sokoto State Command has said that the mission to further implement the Contra General of Customs agenda also include the fight against smuggling activities around Sokoto's border. The area controller said that these men has continued to arrest and intercept goods for smugglers without fear. According to him, his command has continued to discover all kind of track used by smugglers to bring in consignments into the country.
This is yet another method of concealment of contraband goods around Sokoto, Kebbi, Zamfara axis. You can see, like I told you earlier, the smugglers change by the day. We are changing by the hour. They have developed the other idea. They now conceal in a closed van that has dropped goods from the southern part of Nigeria, trying to go back as empty truck. And they now, the smugglers, brought in, recruited the driver of this vehicle to help them convey this one. And you can see they have put nylon on the mouth, telling the driver, this is Nigerian groundnut oil. Unknown to them, we are monitoring them from the day they started filing these jerrycans of vegetable oil. As they are bringing them in small, small vehicles, using Okada machine, stockpiling it in a small village in Kebbi State, we were busy monitoring them. Yesterday, they got this van, they loaded it, we were still following them. They finished, they were on their way to Lagos or to any one part of the southern part of Nigeria. We accosted this vehicle very close to Yawuri in Kebbi State. We have detained it and we now moved it this early morning. By 5:30 a.m., this truck arrived at the headquarters of Sokoto Kebbi Zamfara Command, and you can see the result of this seizure is an information or an intelligence supplied by the intelligence unit of Sokoto Kebbi Zamfara Command. We follow up on the intelligence. We were busy monitoring. He was busy monitoring, but he offered us the information from the beginning, and we follow it up. We have been following them, and we have tracked them down. this is over 300 and something kegs of vegetable oil, which is a prohibited item. Like I said, they keep changing the methodology. Nigeria Customs Service, Sokoto Kebbi Zamfara Command, we are changing our tactics, we are changing our methods. Every hour, every second, every minute, we are with them, we are on their back. We will continue to arrest them, we will continue to get them.
Just before round up this week edition of the program, Customs Report, we brought you a report where Assistant Contractor General of Customs in Zone A has officially handed over to the new ACG in charge of the zone. For me, Igiseme Idine, thanks for watching.